everyone. I'm Neha Bhatnagar, Vice President Partnerships at Impact Investors Council. And it's a pleasure to be here today, sharing the screen with a very noteworthy and influential figure, a celebrated member of IIC for nearly 5 years, and a very dear friend, Mr. Guneet Banga.
Thanks for having me.
Absolutely, it's our pleasure. Guneet, it is unfortunate that while you were at Prabhav 2024, your health did not allow you to be with us and deliver your keynote. You were dearly missed, but we are very thankful to you for giving us this opportunity to interview you today and deliver your message to our network, the audience, and the people who attended Prabhav. I'm sure your insights and perspectives will be really valuable to all of them. Now, before we proceed, I would like to express our sincere gratitude to you, Guneet, and Parinama for your invaluable support as a Platinum Patron of Prabhav 2024. We could not have done it without you. And thank you very much once again for your support.
Always there for you guys. If you need me, just holler.
Thank you. To give everyone a little introduction about you, Guneet, before we dive into the interview. So our audience is well aware of, your accolades. So Mr. Guneet Banga is a founder and managing partner of Parinama. He's also the executive director of the Caravel Group, where he heads Caravel Sustainable Investments. Additionally, he serves as a general partner at Era VC, a Singapore-registered private investment firm. Mr. Guneet Banga also currently serves as a member of the board of the Zubin Foundation, a Hong Kong-based think tank and charity. He's also a member of the fundraising committee. In terms of sustainability credentials, Mr. Banga also holds GRI and PRI professional sustainability certifications and has completed the ESG specialization program from the Corporate Finance Initiative and Global Leading Platforms. We are definitely in good hands, Guneet. With the introduction in place, let's deep dive into the questions.
Sure.
I'm
also on the board of the SFI in Hong Kong, the Sustainable Finance Initiative. So similar to what you guys do, we do in Hong Kong. And as you know, we're trying to build that partnership around the region. So I think that's important to note because I'm trying to drag Chinese families and Hong Kong families in India.
Fantastic. Like I said, Guneet, we are definitely in good hands to take this further.
Yeah, no pressure.
So to start off, Guneet, could you share with us some of the recent initiatives you've been working on? I think everybody at Prabhav wanted to know what you're doing and what Parinama is doing. So it'll help our viewers understand the context of your work.
Basically, Parinama have three main sort of business/operational division segments to start with. One is purely investing with a public investing arm and a private investing arm. The public investing arm is already active in CSI, which will take over. It's essentially, ETFs and transition bond funds and climate bond funds just to generate cash flow to keep the business going, right? So we have very strict kind of, 7%, 5 to 7% gains. We take the gains off the table and park them. We're not greedy. The private side is where we have a number of existing investments, one of which is with a Singapore registered venture capital business, which focuses on deep tech in the climate space as well, called Era VC. We are the largest GP and LP in their first institutional fund, although I don't take an operational role in that at all. I only step in when problems occur and we need to resolve those. Finally, now with, Parinama. I guess I was with Era for about 4 years, learning the ropes and seeing how the impact investing ecosystem around the world worked. And I just thought India was the place to be, given the scale, number of issues, and the government's focus on environment and climate. At Era, it took me 4 rounds with the investment committee to commit to one Indian deal, which is hopefully going to be a 10x multiple from their seed to their Series A within 15 months, and creating massive impact in terms of decarbonization and cleaning the air. So the next one is, I guess, what India has done very well and always has had this entrepreneurial culture. We find solutions where, you know, we shouldn't. We will do whatever it takes to find a solution to a problem that exists. That is that everyone works independently. There's no coordination. There's no sharing of information. And there's no way to see what the cumulative impact or the cumulative effect of all these actors working towards, supposedly towards a net zero goal. I've been working with you guys for the last couple of years, really pushing to get a, first of all, a collaborative that can manage and sector by sector come up with decarbonization plans made up of family offices, DFIs, angels, VCs, who are specialized in various sectors, right? Because they will be best placed to know which technology will be best suited for this current stage in the market. And then beyond that, we are, well, given the responsibility to rebuild, recreate, and I guess instill a level of trust and belief in the Indian private markets. Because, yeah, you know, there's an article that came out a few weeks ago that, you know, the funds, investors, managers are love ESG funds, but investors are shunning them, Indian and global. Yeah. And why is that? Because there's no framework for governance, regulation, you know, minimum standards.
Yeah.
None. So basically we have to create this from scratch. And we want to be the best in the world so that we can attract the capital that India needs and then develop the technology that if you could develop it in India and it works in India, it can be applied anywhere.
Anywhere. Absolutely. So you've so organically moved into my next question, which you've already covered. Why India? So that's beautifully put, Guneet.
Why India? Largest consumer block in the world. 500 million people between the age of 25 and 45, which will be 800 million by 2050. If you cater to their needs, you're catering to most of the needs of the global sort of middle, that age, who will be most affected by climate change, right? 25 years, right?
Absolutely. That's...
Secondly, we have the government showed during D20 how absolutely determined they are to resolve this issue. And Mr. Modi is laser-like focused on this. So the backing of the government, which India rarely gets on one issue, but there's, you know, infights and all that stuff. I think Mr. Modi and some of his sort of stronger, larger portfolio owning inner circle, basically.
Yeah,
are all the same, all the same page, right? And
of course,
I think we shared during G20, India can lead, India must lead. The US is going nowhere, really.
Well, absolutely. Right? India is the strongest growing economy. And I think as much as what we do at ISC as well, we deal with a lot of international investors. The world is looking at India. The India story is unfolding. And I'm so happy that we have leaders like you, you know, taking it from the, you know, from the start. I'm also sort of trying to ask questions on behalf of the audience. And I know that the obvious question from the people sitting at Prabhav would have been that what kind of organizations would Parinama be working with? And secondly, how does Parinama define the word impact?
Well, I think that's not, it's not a decision for me to make, right? We have an ecosystem and we have a collaborative. We've identified sort of 12 to 15 founding members who we will be approaching over the next couple of days, maybe over the weekend, and hopefully have our first meeting right before we have our 10th anniversary with IIC, right? Because it's not my show. It's a collaborative that comes together. I'll be putting together a document on the questions, the key issues, how we frame the next 5 years, basically. I think we take it in five-year blocks, right? And we adjust as we go because things will change. What works today isn't going to work tomorrow or isn't going to be as effective. The one main issue, main thing that I must, I think, need to, we really need to get in the government to approve and to instill is a standardized IMM system for the country. And we've only got three companies working on it together. One foreign company and two Indian companies who've done this sort of thing before. you know, it's going to cost $500 million over 2 years, sector by sector, and then you could aggregate, right? Otherwise, who knows where we are.
So what kind of challenges do you think Parinama can face when you are taking a humongous job of standardizing IMM through, you know,
It's not just Parinama, right? It'll be all be done by...
We'll all do it together. Yes, absolutely.
Collaborative. It could be sharing information, sharing data, open data sourcing, right?
Right.
Every sector will have, every player in every sector will have access to whatever data there is in that sector.
Right.
So I think the first thing we need to do is identify who will lead each sort of working group for the eight sectors that we're involved in, who will be involved in global capital mobilization, who will be leading the, discussions with the government, and then, you know, devise our goals for next year.
Yeah.
Right. And my view is there'll be a lot of building blocks that we need to put in the first year in order to start generating impact the years after that, right? So I think my personal opinion is I will not be investing in more than one technology per month, because I want to stress test the entire system every time.
Understood. No, this is extremely helpful, Guneet. What I hear from you is the word collaboration.
Yeah.
And the emotion behind all your effort is that you are stating the fact that collaboration among stakeholders across sectors and countries is so important. So on behalf of Parinama, is there a collaboration that you're beginning or you're initiating?
Well, I've already started a number in Europe, so partnered with a 50 German family office collaborative entity who actually aren't investors, but they're sustainable company builders. It's like the Siemens company and the Daimler family and people like that who are involved in this, right? And now that we're going to be bringing their technology into India, so the solar panel manufacturer, recyclable solar panels made of plastic, so much cheaper, right? And you can recycle them. And there's also a sort of associated power storage unit where when you're not using the power, it stores it for greenhouse and blackouts. Secondly, there's a family out of Copenhagen, which has an 80-family multifamily office, you know, billion-dollar families, all these guys, right? And they are very, very keen on India because of, well, they see the benefits, right? These guys know that if we get it right, and it'll be on us as Parinama and also as the other members of the ICIC to set an example by walking the walk and working with the government to come up with, policies and regulations that are friendly to foreign investors and local investors, protective of startups and basic standards for whatever, due diligence, et cetera, have standardized processes, governance, code of conduct, ethical framework, which people, like much like the UNGC, you are already involved in this, you sign this. And if you, you know, make a mistake, fine. But if you deliberately continue to break these codes, sorry, we won't do business with you. All know that there are a number of many, many entities who are only there to make a quick buck. Right. And I don't want that. I want people who are in it for 25 years, willing to take big risks, willing to lose money in the short term, because they're looking at it from their great grandkids and great grandkids perspective.
This is fantastic, Guneet. And this urges me to sort of again organically move into what's going on globally currently on the news everywhere is COP29. Yep. And, you know, there are immense number of, you know, India, everybody's looking at India, but important dialogues going on there, like, you know, the NGCQ and adaptation in particular. It will mean massive increase in both capital required in the systems and, you know, processes used to efficiently direct capital to India. What are your thoughts here? How can, you know, world leaders like you can help on such topics?
All I can do is speak to people and ask them for money. I mean, now I'm building relationships with sort of some of the largest families in the world, right? And in January, I'll be doing a 2-week roadshow in the US, meeting maybe 15 of the top 25 families, excluding certain, you know, let's just say people who aren't aligned in terms of ethics and values and outlook, right? And then in March, we approached doing the European families and also these Scandinavian pension funds who have trillions of dollars under management and can now invest in private sector deals, which they couldn't before, right? And then probably later on is the Middle East, because they view India as their food source. So there's plenty of capital there. Agriculture, agri-tech, they will be probably the lead funders, I would think.
What I hear from you is, a new pool of capital through family offices.
To start with, right? To come in and...
Yes, to start with, absolutely. Yeah. And yeah, and education is very much important to the family offices before inviting them to the platform. What we have heard at ISC from the multiple family offices that we work with, Guneet, that most of the decisions are made on the dining table between the families. How do you think we can encourage more existing and emerging family offices to participate and impact in climate investing? And what I see you are doing, I would call that a movement. You know, with Parinama, you're starting a movement. How can we involve more family offices here?
I'm building social relationships, because that's the advantage that family offices have that funds and investors and companies really don't. We're not ultra competitive. We're united by, you know, friendships and marriages and, you know, this and that, right? So there's less of a competitive, like, cutthroat dynamic. And we can sit down over a meal and have a discussion, civilized, right? Spending weekends with three of the largest European families. Yeah, I'm not going to name them yet because obviously confidentiality reasons, but they are pretty much soft committed between sort of $50 and $75 million to Parinama once we have a lot of structuring in place.
Fantastic.
And we'll be seeded with $25 million, and we will, my family will match whatever is raised up to another $100 million. So,
Guneet, these are the numbers that everybody listening to you need to hear and want to hear and wishes to hear.
Small. I mean, I want the government to, working with a few people to put a framework together and a plan together for the government to issue create a green fund, not just in equity, but in debt as well.
And of course.
Anchor, and then the collaborative can put in some capital, family can put in some capital. And that, absolutely, again, creates confidence for international investors, right?
Absolutely.
So it's going to be a very dynamic process.
Absolutely. And we need leaders like you and Parinama to lead from the front, to become examples and, push more family offices and a pool of capital into impact. Sorry, you were saying.
No, the gating factor here is that there's no easy way for foreigners to get their capital into India and out of India. There's a structure that we've developed out of Singapore where we use their VCCs and set up an SPV underneath the VCC through which the capital can come into India, because Singapore and India have, free open currency trading and things like that. But right, you would have tax incentives, subsidy incentives, and, especially companies who are bringing technology into India should be given subsidies and, partnerships and introduced to their sort of the universe of entities that they'll be working with, right? Their little ecosystem.
Right.
On that note, I'm also going to be taking a stake in, I guess, currently the largest climate professionals ecosystem called Forward VC. So I'll be taking about a 20% stake in that and rebuilding that with a proper management team and a board. And we will have, I've got a lot of great ideas for that, but that's basically going to hopefully be the center of the global ecosystem.
Right. Absolutely. What golden words, Guneet. Now, Guneet, your valuable insights and, incredible work in this space is very inspiring. But what I really, on behalf of the audience, what we really need is a visionary. And that's what we see in you. You know, we wish continued success to Parinama. And also a big thank you for your unwavering support for Prabhav. But as a parting note, as a parting note, would you like to leave our audiences with some golden words yet again?
Everybody has a role to play. It doesn't matter how big or how small.
Fabulously said.
Everyone has to be involved. We win together or we lose together. That simple.
Fantastic. Fantastic. It's so well put. So well put. So with that note, on that note, Guneet, thank you so much. I must reiterate that we missed you in person at Prabhav. It would have been amazing to have you there, but here's to many more. And here's to...
We'll be there in December, right? At the 10th anniversary. Yes.
Absolutely. We look forward to having you there.
Bringing you your sasikaya.
And I wish you... Sorry?
Celebrating.
Celebrating, absolutely. And
finally now announced and now...
It's been
starting,
10.
Starting to be... No, I'm saying for me, two years of basically killing myself, sleeping 2-3 hours a night.
Absolutely.
And I'm looking forward to next year. I think it's going to be challenging. I think there's going to be people who are naysayers, who are going to throw stones for no reason, and that's all they do. And you know what? People like that, I say, you know what? Stop criticizing, get in the game. Use that energy in a positive way.
Absolutely.
Right.
So well put. So well put with those golden words. Thank you very much, Guneet. And thank you, Parinama team. We look forward to much stronger assignments in the future and building the world together with you.
Absolutely. I'm very open to, you know, people having different views, and my whole philosophy is diversity, openness, ethics, integrity, and a long-term view, and working together and supporting each other.
Fantastic.
You can't win this battle without that.
Couldn't have put it better. Thank you so much, Guneet, with that. We look forward to seeing you again, and thank you very much for your time. Thank you.
A couple of weeks. Thanks. Thanks, Neha.
Thank you.
All right. See you soon. Thank you, audience.
All right. Thank you, audience.